Hi, this is Dr. Chua, presenting today a hysteroscopy finding for tubo-ovarian abscess and adenomyosis. So this is how it will look like in a typical hysteroscopic examination. So as you can first see here, the cervical canal, especially the endocervical canal and the junction between the uterine body and the uterine cervix, is actually stenosed. So when encountered with this situation, it's good to have a Bugatti shaver to do direct shaving to gain access. However, if you do not have a Bugatti shaver or true clear, you can also use hydrodissection and a gradual entry, as you can see here. Now this stenosis has been overcome by hydrodissection and the hysteroscopy alone. So once you have entered, you can see a very grossly inflamed erythematous and as well as small pockets of adenomyosis infiltrating into the uterine wall. You can see the brownish discharge here, which is actually the menstrual blood or the abnormal content that precipitates into the uterine myometrium, resulting in adenomyosis. And now the source of the discharge or bleeding is being located, but it is rather difficult because there's a lot of sediment. Here you can see the left ostium here, which has been visualized. However, the right ostium remains to be seen, but you can note the grossly involved adenomyotic myometrium. Here is the left ostium. So once you have located the fundus of the uterus, what you do is then gradually shift from one end to the other laterally. You can see here again more precipitate as well as pus-like discharge is being seen arising from the other end of the uterine cavity from the right lateral side. So you can see here the active discharge, which is blood and pus, is being seen discharging from the right ostium here. So this is a rather classical sign. So if you have a tubo-ovarian abscess and if you relieve the uterine pressure during hysteroscopy by releasing the hydrostatic distension, you will see the pus coming up from one end of the fallopian tube, just like this here. So this is a case of a right-sided tubo-ovarian abscess with active discharge, as well as patient having adenomyosis with the pockets and locules of blood extending into the myometrium, as you can see here. Thank you. I hope you enjoy this presentation and have a nice day.